Hey, this is the Daily Overpass. My name is Eric and I make apps. Today, let's ask the question, what bugs are worth fixing? Okay, so a couple of days ago, we did a video about troubleshooting live applications and how difficult it can be with mobile, right, with analytics and everything like that. And there was a really good comment that came in on that video from Bojam Orama, who said, "Nice episode. In my first app, I didn't put analytics and was so happy my app was hardly crashing. After installing analytics, I found out that Google Console only reports a small percentage of crashes and had to fix a substantial amount of bugs." Okay, I didn't know that about only being the small percentage. Anyway, I'm curious about two things here. What is your policy for fixing bugs? For example, in my apps, I have some bugs that I don't fix because they are hard to reproduce and they happen on less popular devices. Number two, what is your take on exceptions? For example, I prefer the apps crash instead of going into unpredicted behavior. I discussed this with some other devs and some share a similar opinion, but some are strongly strongly believe that your app should never crash no matter what. So the first one, what are the my policies on fixing bugs? As a software developer, I always fix bugs. But as a business owner, not so much. So it depends on if it's a client application and they come to us with a bug, and it has to be within a certain period. They can't come back like 2 years later and say, "Oh, this one person has this issue." Right? They have to accept the fact that maybe it might not be working on a certain Android version, or there might be upgrades and everything like that. And if they want us to look at it, then they have to pay for it. But there's like a warranty period after it goes live, so we'll do it there then. And it's also part of professional pride as a software developer. If you've ever worked for any software development company, you know there's going to be times where you put something live and like within 2 hours you think, "Ooh, that was that one little thing that, you know, and you can fix it in 2 seconds." And sometimes you're lucky enough that you just can, right? You just go in there and do that. It depends on the policies of wherever you're working. All right, so there's that. But as a business owner, when I have apps live on the market and they're making money, it really depends on how well they're doing and how many people it affects. So like I have a Trello board with a bunch of things that I need to fix on some of the smaller applications, and they're not really very urgent because the apps don't really make a lot of money, and I could spend, one of these days I'm just gonna spend an entire day and go through there and just do those and re-release them, and but it's not really on the urgency scale. It's like, it's the whole 80-20 thing. Like, say, I'm a big believer in minimum viable products, right? So if you've ever read the Lean Startup, I mean, I think that this is the one that popularized the minimum viable products. However, if you say MVP, I hate it when people say MVP. So many developers say, "Yeah, Eric, we need to do an MVP." And I'm thinking, that means most valuable player, right? So if you ever say that to me and I wince, that's why. So I believe in the minimum viable product. I believe a lot of developers spend too much time trying to make their apps perfect before they ever go live, and sometimes they never go live. So for me, I'm thinking, we don't know anything until the users start using it, so let's get something out there. And if we find a bug at the time, we'll evaluate it then, right? And sometimes the app just tanks and it's not really worth doing, so that's where we'll go with it. So, but if it's for a client, then that's different because, you know, they're paying for the work. Otherwise, I'm paying for the work, if you hear what I'm saying there. So, and then what is your take on exceptions? This is a really good one, because my entire career has been, your app should never crash, right? Your whatever it is, website, whatever, like if you get to a page that says, like a stack trace error or something like that, your app has failed. It should always be handled. Every error should always be handled. That's my take on it. However, and I talk about this with our developers too. However, you can't see the stack trace, right? That only really works if you're handling everything. So if you have like a global exception handler and you're taking that final stack trace, like if that stack trace bubbles up and then it's actually getting reported someplace so you know what to do with it, then that makes sense. And then you could like show your user something like, "We're having trouble with this application now," or something like that, rather than it just crashes. But it's really hard to do on mobile. And I think, and that's also the case, like you were saying, you could have something that's behaving the way you don't expect it to because your app is handling it so well. So let's say your app needs internet access and you haven't handled that properly, right? So would you want it to just crash if it tries to access the internet and it can't, or would you want it to say, "You need to access the internet, you need to be able to access the internet," etc. But there's always going to be things that you don't know. So the crashing should only happen for the totally unanticipated errors. Like you just didn't know it was coming, right? And I still like the idea of it coming up saying, there's a problem with this application now, please call back or something, or reporting back to a logging system. But I think it's kind of goes both ways. I could see both sides of the argument. For me, like for some of the apps that we put out there, like I just, you know, I'm fine with it just crashing. But I mean, well, nobody's fine with it crashing. If it's crashed, means something's gone wrong that you did not anticipate. But it's better doing that you can see what it is rather than it just sits there and floats and like it's they're still clicking around on stuff. And so for some reason, it's just not working right. Yeah, that's my thing. But I'd be really interested to hear what you guys have to say about this because this is a really good question, right? Is it better for an app to crash? Or is it better to get an error and then, well, to get an error silently, which obviously I don't think it is, or to report back to analytics server someplace. And if you have a really cool solution that you're using, let us know in the comments because I'd like to hear about that too. So anyway, Bojan, really good questions today. That's it for today. I will talk to you guys again tomorrow.